I'll try to get you out of here as quick as possible. In the 33rd verse, and when you find it, say amen. St. John, the 16th chapter, and the 33rd verse. Let me hear some more amens.
Amen.
These things have I spoken unto you, that in me, I want you all to catch this, that in who? In me, this is Jesus talking, ye might have peace. Somebody help me say peace. In the world, ye shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. Somebody just say with me this morning, keep the peace. Thank you, Jesus. You can have your seat. That we're supposed to be police officers for the law. We are supposed to be keeping the peace, Mother Preston, not disturbing the peace. Anybody out here this morning? We are supposed to be, Brother Joe, keeping the peace. If the Zimmerman man in Florida would have been, in my opinion, and I'm not saying he's wrong because I know this is going out over, keeping the peace like he's supposed to be keeping the peace and identifying himself as to who he was, then he might not be in jail now. And cannot get out. Because one detective said, you had at least two occasions to appease that situation that that child, that young man, would not be dead. Saints, I don't know about y'all, but I'm going to keep the peace. I'm going to keep it in my life. And let me move on. Did you know that you can have peace even in the midst of difficult circumstances? Many people are trying to get rid of their problems, hoping that they will then be happy. Are y'all hearing me? Then they can start enjoying their life. But God wants us to learn to have peace in the midst of the storm. He wants us to have peace even when things aren't going our way. Y'all ever run up on somebody? Sister Radice, don't bother me today. It ain't my day. I ain't had my coffee today. You don't need no coffee to have peace in your life. Amen. So, keep the peace when you when they're not going your way. When your boss isn't treating you right. You didn't get the promotion that you wanted. Your child isn't doing what he or she should. If we make the mistake of basing our peace on our circumstances, we'll never experience what God has in store for us. Thank you, Lord. Because something, somebody help me say something, will always come along to upset you. If you're waiting to have peace to praise God, you ain't never going to give him no praise. Because the devil is always going to keep something going on that'll keep trouble that's running in your life. Huh? The Apostle Paul experienced all kinds of heartache. People done him unfair and done unfair things to him, and others had lied about him. I know how you feel. You know, praise God, I can't tell nobody that has lost their mother. Y'all know how folks tell you they know how you feel. Don't tell folks that when the same situation have not happened to you. Are y'all hearing me? Praise God. If somebody done lost their mother, praise God, I can't tell them I know how they feel. I can say I can imagine how you feel. Because why? My mama is still sitting over there. Praise God. It kills me when folks are always trying to tell you about something that they ain't never been through. Huh? Praise the Lord. Amen. And so therefore, I'm telling you this morning, keep the peace. People, praise God, never, in spite of all of the things that we go through. We are more than conquerors. How many of y'all are conquerors this morning? You're not going to lie here and say the devil make you think that you're not going to make it. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm going, yes, I am going to make it. Praise God. One time occasion when James Cleveland was in the hospital and he was sick, and amen, the nurse walked out of the room and looked at another nurse, a doctor, and looked back and said, I don't think he's going to make it. And James Cleveland said, he don't know how. Brother Joe, he said, somehow, praise the Lord. He said, I don't know how, but he raised up off of that bed and said, yes, I am going to make it too. And you need to look at your neighbor and say, I don't know how, but I'm going to make it somehow. Praise the Lord. Oh, my God. Praise God. See, I can tell you what it means to be potent. Amen. It was 13 of us, isn't that right, Brother Preston? And I'm the fourth one out of 13. We were so potent, it didn't have the other O-R on the end of it. We were P-O, praise the Lord, with a capital P. Y'all ain't saying that. But I want to let you know this morning, don't use your faith to get rid of your problem. Use your faith to remain calm in the midst of your problem. Jesus was asleep on a small boat when suddenly a huge storm arose. And the wind was fierce and strong and batting the boat back and forth. And the disciples all got upset and they were afraid. And then somebody finally said, Jesus, wake up. Please get up. Don't you care that we perish down here? Jesus got up, praise the Lord. And this is what I love about the Lord. If you would pattern yourself after the life of God, you would have to go through a lot of the things that you're going through. Because Jesus got up and just calmly spoke to the wind and said, peace, be still. Amen. Somebody on the hip and said, peace, be still. Amen. Praise the Lord, peace. And yesterday the wind subsided and the sea turned into a blessed calm. And the reason Jesus was able to bring peace, amen, in that situation, Brother Joe, amen, because he had peace down on the inside of him. And I'm wondering this morning, how many of you that are sitting up here in the house of God that are going through trials and tribulation? Amen. And though Jesus was in the storm, he didn't let the storm get on the inside of him. Look at your neighbor and tell him, said, neighbor, you can be in the storm, but don't let the storm get in you. Amen. Peace is not necessarily the absence of trouble, nor is it always the absence of your enemies. You can have trouble and conflict all around you on the outside, but you can have real peace down on the inside. Praise the Lord. You know, bless the Lord. You change on the inside, missionary person. I wish I had somebody do what I was talking about. Bless the Lord when you can change down on the inside of you. Bless God, Brother Joe, when I used to crank up my car and head toward Hattiesburg, my head used to start hurting. But I made a change. I wish I had somebody down on the inside of me that I wasn't going to let nobody trouble me. I wasn't going to let nobody. I wish I had a prayer in church. Steal my joy. Come on and tell him thank you. Peace is not, amen, what you are looking for, but it's got to be down on the inside. Amen. You may be upset, Brother David, and worried about some aspects of life. Perhaps you're concerned about your finances. Is anybody out there this morning? Or there's a situation at work that is unjust, it is unfair, and you are letting that situation rile you on the inside. But day after day, it weighs on you, draining your joy, draining your energy, draining your enthusiasm. Amen. You have let the storm, and when this happens to you, you have let the storm get on the inside of you. Look at your neighbor and say, don't let the storm get on the inside. As soon as I get through this, then you say, I'm going to get back to being my normal self. But Brother Draper, you know, you know that when this challenge is over, there will be something else that can steal your peace. You got to change your approach. Mother President, stop allowing, and y'all, I'm going to get out of here, those things to upset you. Instead of you allowing those things to upset you, Mother President, we got to turn that situation over to God. Praise the Lord, we must come to the altar and tell the Lord, I am your child. Amen. And I know that stormy winds are going to blow. And praise the Lord, I know that my name is going to be on the highway. But I understand that until you get to this place of peace, that God can't really work in your life. Praise the Lord, God want to work in some of your life. How many of you want God to work in your life this morning? Amen. If you want God to work in your life, you need to turn it over to the Lord. And understand that until you get to this place of peace, that God can really work in your life. The way that God will work in your life. Because God works where there is an attitude of faith. Expectancy. If you are not expecting nothing, missionary, if you're not gonna get nothing from God, if you get up with the same old same, if you keep doing the same old thing, you wanna keep on getting the same old result.
Don't live a life of fear. Don't live a life of fear. I want you to look at your neighbor and say, look her in the eyes and say, neighbor, $10,000 and we can stay long. Don't mean to say anything.